Good afternoon, friends. Welcome for this press conference. I'm sorry we are a little late, but I was glad I could talk to all of you on one-to-one basis. It helped me to express my views and also understand all of you. Particularly, this press conference is to show to the people of the English media how people are frustrated with the KCR government. People have realized that this Dubbak victory will definitely open up several new avenues, new combinations, and will teach KCR a big lesson. Until now, KCR was thinking that he is a dictator, he can do what he wants, he can be corrupt to the hilt, and nobody will question him. The whole emphasis is coming to the massive corruption KCR has done over a period of 6 years. We have been telling several times that the Kaleshwaram project, which was only 36,000 crores, where already 11,000 crores was spent in the garb of redesigning, in the garb of he thinking that he is an engineer, he is only an MSc political science person, but just to make commissions and money, he has inflated the project cost to 1 lakh crores. Now, people of Telangana are really suffering on account of this. As we have seen recently, all his promises which he gave to the people of Telangana, particularly double bedroom houses and also 3 acres land to the Dalits, every household I'll give you one job to the youths, these he failed utterly because he has diverted all the monies wherever possible for the Kaleshwaram 1 project. It is already 3 years over. Not a single drop of water has been utilized from Kaleshwaram. So obviously, nowhere in the world a project was constructed on a river. It should actually, barrage should have been somewhere else, because now he is not able to do, because water is coming from the by gravity and he is not able to pump the water. Even this year, as per their project report, they are supposed to take the flood water for 90 days at 2 TMC per day. He is not able to do, but he has gone and called tenders for 3 TMC. So, the purpose of my saying is, KCR has become the most corrupt chief minister in this country. He has diverted all the resources. He has brought this state to a debt of 4 lakh crores from 60,000 crores. So, 60,000 crores to 4 lakh crores, and where has all the money gone? Nobody knows. Whereas, if you see properly, the assets of KCR have grown multifold, and there are serious charges of corruption. Actually, I was going through one report which said Telangana is the second most corrupt state in the country, and by KCR's misgovernance and his pensions to make commissions in the garb of redesigning, he has made huge assets which need to be probed by the central government. We have told the central government, we have made a representation to them that KCR is misusing his power by making a lot of money, increasing the debt of the state, and by increasing the debt of the state, he is having more leverage to make more money in the form of commissions. So this is a point which we want the center to act against this chief minister of having taken Telangana state to the most corrupt state in the country. And the people of Dubbak, they have said, we thought that when Telangana comes, we'll all get jobs, we'll all get double bedroom houses, but this chief minister has given jobs to all his family members. He went on record to say that I need one person as a Rajya Sabha member who can give me medicines in the night. That is the arrogance in which the chief minister, being in power, the power of being a chief minister, and the amount of money he made as a chief minister, that has gone to his head. That is why he had the arrogance. He has forgotten all the people who have struggled to get Telangana. If you see properly, nobody is there who fought and brought Telangana. All his henchmen who are from different parties, he has ensured that only people who don't have a voice are there. So people of Dubbaga have said, no, this is not correct. This is not the Telangana what we fought for and we brought. We thought there will be a democratic Telangana. We thought Telangana will develop. We thought we'll get jobs. We thought we'll get water. At getting water also by irrigation projects has to be in a proper economic way of getting water. But here, I was surprised when I went to see Malana Sagar. He has created facilities for 50 TMC in Malana Sagar. There the farmers were getting 3 crops already. And he has taken their lands at such a low rates of 7.5 lakhs. Whereas in North constituency, he has given more than 20 lakhs per acre as compensation. So this discrimination, which this chief minister thought that nobody will have the power to oppose him or raise a voice against him, because he has bought over all the MLAs, the press is not reporting anything correctly against KCR. So he thought the best way to function is wipe out the opposition, suppress the media, and ensure that he does what he wants. So this dictatorial family rule of KCR, I have told several times, when the corona was going on, instead of converting the secretariat into a good isolation center, where more than 10,000 people could have been housed there, and saved many of the people have paid more than 3 lakhs as hospital bills, which could have been avoided. He neither gave them Ayushman Bharat, which Prime Minister Modi announced a central government scheme, nor brought corona into the Arogya Sri scheme. He has and demolished the secretariat. So he is ruling Telangana like a Tughlaq, Muhammad bin Tughlaq. Everybody has heard how Tughlaq shifted his capital from Delhi to Daulatabad and then introduced new currency. This chief minister is just doing like that. In the garb of redesigning, he has inflated the project cost, he is making commissions, he is demolishing secretariat. He wanted to demolish Erramanzil, which was stopped by this thing. He is not providing double bedroom houses, even whatever few double bedroom houses he has constructed in very far off places, which are not useful to the middle class people. The simple scheme was, we have seen the recent national elections, Prime Minister Modi won in all the states going in for elections and also the by-elections, because a lot of people benefited from all the good central government schemes he has come up with, particularly on the housing. Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana, a lot of people have built houses under that scheme. Here the chief minister is not utilizing this scheme properly, despite our minister saying, please come up with as many houses as possible, the central government is ready to fund. So BJP is here to stay. This chief minister is feeling the heat that BJP is emerging as a good national party. So he is misusing the police. He is bringing the state to a constitutional breakdown. He is misusing the police. Like we have seen in the Dubbaq election, the candidate is standing in Dubbaq. His in-laws were there in a different constituency, Siddipet. There he was raided, he was harassed. And our state president was, along with me, he was arrested and pushed into the car. So he is misusing the police. And in Hyderabad, he claims, the police commissioner claims that he has caught 1 crore rupees of Mr. Srinivas Rao, who is not connected with my company and Visakha Industries. And he has given a press conference saying that 1 crore rupees, which was meant for Dubbaq, was done. So this is the kind of harassment he was doing. So I gave a statement immediately saying that the money is with the chief minister's farmhouse and his Pragati Bhavan. Really, police has the guts. You have to go and raid him there and dig out all the money which he has made through the commissions. And I am warning the chief minister that no matter what, we are continuing this struggle against you. No force on earth can stop us from exposing you. We will fight. I will definitely file a defamation case against the chief minister and the police commissioner for dragging into my name. Elections are in Dubbaq. He's talking about Hyderabad, and our office is not connected. It was somewhere outside the office, and our records are very clear. Our auditor has already when he did the auditing for the second quarter, he's already said everything is very clear here. So this kind of a suppression which the chief minister is doing, all our BJP cadre people have been arrested left, right and center even before the counting. So we are going to fight against him. This kind of tyranny which this chief minister is unleashing on the people of Telangana will not be tolerated, and is beginning of the end of his days is coming. We are confident that the central government will institute an inquiry against this chief minister for corruption, because we are going to give all the details, which are the areas in which he has made huge sums of money and taken this state into a debt state. Today he doesn't have money to pay the salaries of the employees, and this is a serious matter, and we'll definitely pursue with the central government to take action against this chief minister. Thank you. Generally, BJP, after our new president Mr. Sanjay has come, there is a big motivation amongst the BJP cadre to fight for the people, to take up people's issues and highlight. If you see recently, the agricultural bill, which was important, which had an MSP price, the chief minister said MSP price will not be there, market committees will not be there, but the cat is out of the bag, that in the recent crop which the farmers took out in the recent times, the MSP price announced by the center, 1850, he was forced to give because of the agitation by BJP cadre. He was not willing to give more than 1150 rupees, but because Prime Minister Modi's assurance was there that MSP will not be withdrawn, he was forced to give 1850 rupees. Even now, on the fine rice, which he threatened the farmers of Telangana, saying that if you don't put fine rice and cotton, I will not give you Raitu Bandhu. So now, because of his pressure, because of his Tughlaq governance, because without conducting a soil survey, how can you say which soil will give good productivity of which crop? But this gentleman has an idea in the night and he tries to announce it in the morning. And BJP is fighting for this. You better give 1850 plus a bonus, because you force them to put those crops. And you have to give, because the poor farmers, they are all very hardworking people, and they need to be supported by the government. And the government, when you force them to put this crop, it's the duty of the state government to give them a support price in addition to the MSP price. And during the agricultural bill, he opposed it. And today the farmers are getting benefited out of this agricultural bill. And most important is, we are going to expose the chief minister at every stage. And the result clearly showed in Dubai that people have realized that the lies, the half-truths, which this chief minister is an expert at, he used to actually mayajal the people by his sweet talk. But people have realized that this guy only speaks lies. Because they have seen that only one family has got 6 cabinet posts, including the chairman of the deputy chairman of the planning commission. There are 7 people as trustees to the Tirumala Tirupati Devasthanam from his family and friends. And this is the kind of governance he's doing. So people are silently watched. They said, yes, we have given you a chance as a Telangana chief minister, but we can't tolerate your corruption. That is the message of Dubak. It was a vote against the corruption of the chief minister and the arrogance of this chief minister. This misgovernance as a Tughlaq which he's doing in Telangana. And it is a starting point, and I want to address the press that the number of phone calls which we are getting from well-wishers, from people who are so happy that TRS has been taught a lesson. So it shows that the people of Telangana are frustrated with this chief minister, but they didn't have a voice. BJP has given them a voice by winning this Dubak election. I have just told you, the Kaleshwaram project, the Mission Bhagirathi project, which was already there, 70% of the drinking water pipelines were laid already. Yeah, but you see, you must also understand one thing. Until it is told to somebody at the Delhi that these are the places where corruption has taken place, They won't understand. We have now told them which are the areas in which they have done. Actually, if you see the motors in Kaleshwaram project, the cost at which Mega Engineering has supplied to the state government versus what Mega Engineering is supplying to BHEL, you know the difference. We have shown all this evidence to them. So definitely there is a need here. How the project cost has been inflated, and if you see properly, the Central Water Commission or the ministry has asked the Chief Minister, please give us the details of the project cost and the expenses incurred. This gentleman is not submitting it. The Chief Minister is not submitting it. He is masking it. And without approval of the central government, he has already announced the third TMC. We have not used the two TMC. And because of commissions, he has already announced the third TMC. We are only requesting by first implement the two TMC project successfully, benefit the farmers, and then increase it to three TMC. Even in there, he should have done it by the canal method. But there, because Mega Engineering is in the supply of pipes, he has used those pipes for the three TMC also. It's a disaster the way he is governing. You will keep watching what will happen in the coming days. Then we'll discuss. If you don't see any results, you can question me again. Please give me some time. Yeah. एक विषय आपको तो जानते हैं, पॉलिटिक्स में हर एक चीज होता है. पॉलिटिक्स में बिगनिंग में यस, तेलंगाना गवर्नमेंट नया गवर्नमेंट है, अच्छा काम करेगा सोचे बीजेपी वाले, तो दे सपोर्टेड. बट नाउ आफ्टर सिक्स इयर्स जो मिस गवर्नेंस हो रहा है तेलंगाना में, इट इज इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर बीजेपी टू टेक इट अप एज अ कॉज. And they have taken up now. When we have presented the evidence to them, they have taken up, and we are going to fight against the corruption of this chief minister. Abhi mila hai na bhai Dubag mein bataye, Dubag mein the central leadership support karne se hamare ko bhi himmat badh gaya, hum bhi jaake acha lad sake wahan. Aur ye jo rashtra mein jo police ko misuse kar raha hai mukhyamantri, ye issue bhi hum log center mein lene wale hain, that they have to take action against the confidential reports of these police officers who are misusing the power they have. Yes, friend. I am in the process, because there is a big process for that. I believe you have to file a police complaint, give a notice. So that initiation internal initiation has started. In the coming 10-15 days, you will see that I would have filed the defamation. No, why should I have any? Up till now, whatever I have given so forcefully against the Chief Minister, High Command never told me anything up till now. They are supporting, because it is a fight against the state Chief Minister's tyranny on the people of Telangana. Why will High Command put pressure on us? We are raising issues which he has been conducting unconstitutionally. So naturally, High Command will support us. See, the Chief Minister has a knack of trying to talk what suits to him. You have just seen in the press that under the disaster management, 290 crores was released to the state immediately. Then again, a further 290 to 260 crores was given. Totally 542 crores has been released from center to state. The chief minister is bluffing by saying that center has not given any assistance. And he has a knack of trying to project it the other way around. So now all the potholes which are there, they are all coming out. And definitely, even in the distribution of these 10,000 rupees, during the Samagra survey, all account numbers of all the households were taken. During the COVID time, when subsidy was given to the general people, it all went in their accounts. Why is it drawn 330 crores this time in the garb of giving 10,000 rupees to the people who were affected by the floods? The TRS cadre has taken back 5,000 rupees. People are protesting everywhere. So there is money here given by the center. He doesn't admit anywhere. Everybody knows that even in the 1 kilo subsidized rice, center is having a subsidy of 29 rupees on that. But he has gone and claimed that everything is given by the central government. So this kind of a false propaganda, BJP is exposing, and he will be on the mat on the mistakes he is doing. Will definitely expose him. Whatever defeat for the development of Hyderabad. You have seen last 3 years how the roads in Hyderabad were potholes all over the place. There is no designing. when the state's debt has gone to 4 lakh crores, what stopped the state government from investing 10,000 crores for the drainage system in Hyderabad? Why they didn't do? 6 years, no? We have been talking about this for the last 6 years. So it is only an eyewash which Mr. KTR is promising. Actually, he is a failure. He was a failure as a working president. They have lost 7 SM parliament seats. They have lost Dubbak under his working presidentship. And as municipal administration minister, this disaster which took place recently, he has not planned anything. And the roads, you know how the status of the roads were. People were actually screaming at the state government for their failure to provide good roads. Even in the roads, central government has released recently 200 crores. So what they are claiming and what they have actually shown actually to the people, there's a lot of difference. And the coming GHMC elections results will be on similar lines like Dubbak. And he will understand that he can't fool the people every time. Okay?
Dubbak Vijayamo Prajala Vijayam. Prajalu ఈ ముఖ్యమంత్రి ఏదైతే తుగ్లక్ లెక్క పరిపాలన చేస్తున్నాడు, ఈ రాష్ట్రానికి నాశనం చేస్తున్నాడు. హామీలు ఇస్తాడు, మాయా మాటలు చెప్తాడు, తప్పుడు ప్రచారాలు చేసి ఇప్పటివరకు గెలుచుకుంటూ వచ్చినాడు. ఆయనకు ఒకటే ఒక మైండ్లో ఫిక్స్ అయిపోయింది, పైసలు ఇస్తే ఓట్లు వేస్తారు ప్రజలని ఆయన అనుకుంటున్నాడు. అందుగురించి కాళేశ్వరం కమిషన్లు తిని ప్రజల ఓట్లు కొనాలని ఈసారి కూడా ప్రయత్నం చేసినాడు. కానీ ప్రజలు అనుకున్నారు, అరే ఈ పైసలు మాయే కదా, మాకు ఈ ఒక్కసారి పైసలు తీసుకొని ఓటేస్తే 5 సంవత్సరాలు పోతాయి. మేమందరము అనుభవించినాము ఈ ముఖ్యమంత్రి ఎట్లా పరిపాలన చేసినారో. మాకు డబుల్ బెడ్రూమ్ ఇల్లు రాలే, మాకు ఇల్లు, మాకు ఉద్యోగాలు రాలేదు, మాకు ఎక్కడైతే పోలీస్ కూడా ఇష్టం వచ్చినట్టు వాడు టీఆర్ఎస్ కార్డర్ వాడుకుంటున్నారు, ఇసుక దంద నడుస్తుంది, టీఆర్ఎస్ వాళ్ళు మంచిగా అవుతున్నారు, వాళ్ళ ఆస్తులు పెరుగుతున్నాయి, ముఖ్యమంత్రి ఆస్తులు పెరుగుతున్నాయి. కానీ మా రాష్ట్రానికి ఒక అప్పుల రాష్ట్రం చేసి ఏదైతే పరిపాలన చేస్తున్నాడో మంచిది కాదని ఇది ఒక ఫౌండేషన్ లే చేసినారు దుబ్బాక్ ప్రజలు. వాళ్ళ ధైర్యం చూసి ఇతర ప్రాంతాలలో తెలంగాణలో చాలామంది నాకు ఫోన్ చేశారు, మా సంజయ్ గారికి ఫోన్ చేశారు, సార్ చాలా మంచిగా చేస్తున్నారు, మేము చాలా సంతోషిస్తున్నాము, ఈ ఏదైతే పరిపాలన ఉందో నియంతృత్వ పరిపాలన ఇది పోవాలని చెప్పి అందరు కూడా ఎదురు చూస్తున్నారు. ఇది ప్రజల విజయము. ప్రజలేమో బీజేపీ మంచిగుంటే బీజేపీని ఓటేశారు. రఘునందన్ మంచి అభ్యర్థి, వారు కూడా తెలంగాణ ఉద్యమంలో పనిచేస్తున్నాడు, వారు కూడా గెలిస్తే మంచిగా ఉంటుందని చెప్పి ఈ మూడు కాంబినేషన్లో కేసీఆర్ ఓడిపోయాడు.
సార్, ఇక్కడ ఇంకొక స్టేట్మెంట్ వినిపిస్తుంది టీఆర్ఎస్ పార్టీ తరఫున, ఏంటంటే ఇండిపెండెంట్ అభ్యర్థికి కార్ లాంటి సింబల్ ఉన్నటువంటి రొట్టె పేక సింబల్ ఉండడం వల్లే ఇటు పడాల్సిన ఓట్లు అటుపడ్డాయి కాబట్టి టీఆర్ఎస్ ఓడిపోయింది.
ఏ ఎప్పుడు ఇదే చెప్తారు వాళ్ళు పోయి ఆల్రెడీ ఎలక్షన్ కమిషన్లో లాస్ట్ టైం ఆల్రెడీ రిప్రజెంట్ చేసి వాళ్ళే కొన్ని సింబల్స్ తీపించుకున్నారు. ఓడిపోయినప్పుడు ఒప్పుకోవాలి వాళ్ళు ఆ ఒక్క విషయం మర్చిపోతున్నారు. 2018 ఎలక్షన్లో 89,000 ఓట్లు వచ్చింది టీఆర్ఎస్కి, ఈసారి 62,000 ఓట్లు వచ్చినాయి. అంటే ఎన్ని ఓట్లు పోయినాయి వాళ్ళు తక్కువ, 27,000 ఓట్లు టీఆర్ఎస్కి తగ్గినాయి. బీజేపీకి 63,000 ఓట్స్ వచ్చినాయి, కాంగ్రెస్కి 22,000 ఏదో వచ్చింది. అంటే 89,000 పీపుల్ హ్యావ్ ఓటెడ్ అగెన్స్ట్ టీఆర్ఎస్. మళ్ళీ ఇది సింబల్ గురించి పోయింది, ఏంటి అది పిల్లల పరిష్కారం.
దీంతో పాటు మీరు ఒక డిఫమేషన్ కేసు కూడా ఇప్పుడు టీఆర్ఎస్ గవర్నమెంట్ మీద, అంటే ఎస్పెషల్లీ కేసీఆర్ గారి మీద వేస్తానంటున్నారు. సో అది ఏంటి, ఎలా ఉండదు?
అంటే మొన్న 1 కోటి రూపాయలు బయట దొరికితే అది నా పైసలు అని చెప్పి నన్ను ఇరికించడానికి ప్రయత్నం చేస్తున్నాను. ఎందుకంటే మేము ముఖ్యమంత్రి వ్యతిరేకంగా కొట్లాడుతున్నాము, డెఫినెట్లీ విల్ ఫైట్. అలాంటి సమయంలో ఏదో ఒక కేసు పెట్టి నాకు అప్పుడు తెలంగాణ ఉద్యమంలో కూడా నాకు ఇప్పుడు చిదంబరం గారు యూనియన్ హోమ్ మినిస్టర్ ఉన్నప్పుడు నా మీద చాలా కేసెస్ పెట్టినాడు, ఎన్ఫోర్స్మెంట్, ఇన్కమ్ ట్యాక్స్ అన్ని కేసులు పెట్టినాడు. కానీ అన్నీ ఎదుర్కొన్నా. ఈసారి కూడా ముఖ్యమంత్రికి హెచ్చరిస్తున్నా, నాకు మీద ఏ కేసు పెట్టుకున్నా పెట్టుకో, కానీ ఈ డిఫమేషన్ కేసు పెడతా నేను ఈ భర్తం పట్టిస్తాను.
సార్, రానున్న జిహెచ్ఎంసీ ఎలక్షన్స్లో బీజేపీ వైఖరి ఎలా ఉండబోతుంది, ప్లానింగ్ ఎలా ఉండబోతుంది? ఎందుకంటే ఇప్పటికీ తెలంగాణ అనేటువంటి సెంటిమెంట్ని గట్టిగా వాడుకుంటుంది టీఆర్ఎస్ పార్టీ.
ఈసారి జిహెచ్ఎంసీ ఎలక్షన్స్లో ప్రజలు చూస్తున్నారు ఈ ముఖ్యమంత్రి వర్షాలు వచ్చినప్పుడు ఇక్కడ ఒక్కసారి కూడా విజిట్ చేయలేదు, కానీ ఫామ్ హౌస్లో కూర్చొని తమాషా చూసుకుంటూ కూర్చున్నాడు. కరోనాలో ఇంతమంది ఇబ్బందులు పడినప్పుడు కూడా ఫామ్ హౌస్లో ఉన్నాడు, కానీ ఇక్కడొచ్చి హాస్పిటల్లో మంచి ఫెసిలిటీస్ ఇవ్వాలి, ఇంకెక్కువ బెడ్స్ చేయాలని ఆ ఆలోచన లేకుండే ఈ ప్రజలందరూ కూడా చూస్తున్నారు. ఈ 10,000 రూపాయలు కూడా 5,000 రూపాయలు కమిషన్ తీసుకొని ఇస్తున్నారు, అందరికి ఇవ్వట్లేదు. హౌస్ ఓనర్స్కి ఇస్తా అంటాడు, ఎట్లయితే రైతు బంధులో కౌలు రైతులకు ఇస్తలేడో ఇక్కడ కూడా. అంటే నేను రెంటెడ్ తీసుకున్నప్పుడు నాకు ఇబ్బంది నుక్సాన్ అయినప్పుడు నాకు ఇవ్వాలి కదా, ఇలాంటి తుగ్లక్ నిర్ణయాలు తీసుకుంటున్నాడని చెప్పి బీజేపీ పార్టీకి మంచి సీటు గెలుస్తుంది, స్ట్రాంగ్ పార్టీ ఎమర్జ్ అవుతుంది. 2024లో బీజేపీ రాష్ట్రం తెలంగాణలో వస్తుంది. ఓకే.